It was a crowdfunding campaign meant to raise money from private donors to help build a border wall. Instead, according to prosecutors, it paid for things like jewelry, travel, a boat, a luxury SUV. In a statement, acting Manhattan U.S. Attorney Audrey Strauss accused former White House advisor Steve Bannon and three others of treating the We Build the Wall campaign as a personal piggy bank.
As alleged, the defendants defrauded hundreds of thousands of donors, capitalizing on their interest in funding a border wall to raise millions of dollars, under the false pretense that all of that money would be spent on construction.
The indictment describes an elaborate sleight of hand carried out by Bannon, project founder Brian Colphage, and the other defendants, involving a different charity and various shell accounts, all to disguise where the money was actually going. Back in 2019, Bannon attended an event meant to drum up support for We Build the Wall.
And that's what this wall movement is about. It's to augment and try to show Washington that they're concerned citizens. And those concerned citizens want to start to take action. They actually want to see the wall built.
The campaign's organizers used their ties to President Donald Trump to build legitimacy as they raised more than $25 million from thousands of donors. Trump quickly distanced himself from his former aide.
He was involved likewise in our campaign and for a small part of the administration very early on. I haven't been dealing with him at all. I know nothing about the project other than I didn't like, when I read about it, I didn't like it. I said, this is for government, this isn't for private people. It was showboating and maybe looking for funds.
Bannon and his three co-defendants have been charged with conspiracy to commit wire fraud and money laundering. They're facing up to 20 years in prison.